All right, everybody, Cutco Mike here at the Cutco Mike Mall kiosk, and we're going to create a little content for you. I get this question asked all the time. What is the difference between these two knives? What is the best chef knife? What is the best chopping knife? What is the size difference? Which one do you prefer? So instead of texting you back at all different times of the year, I'm going to make a quick little live video. So maybe you didn't know we make all these. Maybe you have all these. Maybe you're like, whoa, I didn't realize that could be used for that. But we're going to take a couple minutes here and educate you. So the first one we have is the 2166. That is the petite 5-inch Santoku. And this one came out probably about 8 years ago. It's one of the more popular sizes, especially for women. It's real nice and, I would say, just comfortable, easy to handle. It doesn't feel too weighted. It's not too heavy. And most people love the trimmer, right? So if you look here, the trimmer and the Petite Santoku's blade is almost identical, right? So if you love the size of the trimmer and you're like, I'm only a trimmer person, I only like a small knife, the Petite Santoku would be probably the best knife for you for chopping because it's really an extension of your hands. So you can use that and chop, dice, and mince. You have the tip. So the Santoku name means three knives in one. You can slice, chop, and mince. So you can kind of do three things with that. So that's the 2166. That's the 5-inch Santoku. And then right next to it, you can see the difference of a 5 to 7-inch blade. So the 7-inch Santoku is pretty much the same idea, but if you were able to feel these, you could see there's a little bit more weight to it. You can see it has a little thicker handle, right? A little bigger and thicker handle. It does have a nice size, very comfortable to use. A lot of times I say this is a his and hers set, right? The ladies typically like the smaller, the guys like the bigger, and that's not for everybody. But over a course of my 18 years, I would say most women prefer the 5-inch and most guys prefer the 7, right? We want that bigger engine. But yeah, this will be very similar in uses. Carrots, onions, celery, potatoes. You can use it on raw meat. This morning I cut up some skirt steak. The Santokus can be used on raw meat. You just want to keep them away from bones and really frozen stuff. But any kind of raw meat like chicken breasts is fine. But those are your two Santoku knives. Then you have the original here, which is the French Chef. And you can see this is the biggest chef knife we make if you look at all of them kind of next to each other. That is almost a 10-inch blade. It's 9 1/4 inches. And this comes in all the original sets. It also comes in the signature set. So it's a great knife for bigger types of chopping. You typically see this in a restaurant or people that cater will use this to carve like a prime rib or a roast. In my opinion, it'll be best to cut watermelon next to the salmon knife. But let's say you have a row of 3 or 4 carrots and you really want that length to knock out a stack of celery, right? You got a bunch of celery, you got a bunch of carrots, you got a head of lettuce. You want that length there. For most people, this one is a little too long. But for a lot of people that maybe grew up in a restaurant or maybe their dad was a butcher, or maybe they think of a knife, they go, that's a knife I want. But that is the 1725 chef knife. If you're just joining me, we're going through all the different chopping style chef knives. So we just reviewed the 7-inch Santoku, the 5-inch Santoku, and then the French Chef. And then this is the veggie knife. So this is the 1735 veggie knife. This one only comes in the gourmet set or the ultimate set. Hey, I'm doing a video. You have a quick question?
Yeah, where's the food court at?
Food court's all the way down to the left.
All the way down to the left?
Yeah. All right, so food court question at the mall. So this right here is the Chinese-style chopping cleaver-esque piece. So if you compare this with the cleaver, and we did put the cleaver in here because the cleaver is, in an Asian culture, a knife that people use to chop with, right? They do pull out that to chop with. But if you actually look here, see if I can hold these up side by side, you can kind of see there's a difference in thickness and a difference in weight. You can just see in the spine there of the handle and of the tang and the back heel of the blade there. But we did put the cleaver in the chopping review because people do chop with their cleaver. All right, so the veggie knife is the only knife that's all the way flat. So this one here, if you're gonna mince garlic, if you have herbs, if you have parsley, if you have celery, if you have cilantro, it's the only knife that's flat. And then you can scrape the backside with like your onions right off the cutting board. This one's not too heavy. I mean, if you're not used to a bigger knife, it can be maybe heavy for you, but it's not super heavy. A lot of people use this for their butternut squashes, their bigger root-based vegetables. And then you have your petite chef. So if we put these next to each other, you can kind of see there, you have a 9 1/4 inch chef and then a 7 5/8 chef. So you see there's definitely a big difference. The handles are pretty much the same. And then this one here is going to be the workhorse. This is a French style. This is typically in any knife set. You'll see a style like this. Chopping, dicing, mincing. Obviously, you can use it on raw meat. But anytime you hit raw meat with the smooth edge, it's going to dull it up faster than you want. So you always want to typically use this for potatoes, celery, carrots, lettuce, herbs, nuts, anything along the line of produce and chopping, dicing, mincing. So you can kind of see them side by side there. And then you'll get to see the cleaver and the veggie knife. And then a lot of people think, oh, that thing's way too big. But if you got a big old head of cabbage, you got a big old head of lettuce, or if you just want to cut through a big fat potato, this thing will go right through it, right? Just the weight of it. I mean, this thing is, has the biggest handle we make. I mean, the spine on that is huge. That thing is not going to break. But a cleaver is designed mostly for meats and processing and butchering. But a lot of people in an Asian culture, they're used to a cleaver because they use that one knife for everything. So the cleaver could be used as a chopper, right? It definitely has more feel and weight to it. But if you have the ultimate set and you're like, what are all these knives for? Well, here's definitely a walkthrough of all of them. So here's a walkthrough of all of them one more time. So you have the veggie knife, the cleaver, the veggie knife, the petite chef, the French chef, the 5-inch Shantoku, and the 7-inch Shantoku. And I know a few of you have actually heard, and I'm going to make a quick announcement here to hopefully educate you. So Cutco is actually at Costco, and you know that I always match, beat, or honor Costco prices. There's so many reasons to go through me and a rep. I did make a video about it, but the main reason is you get to support me. You get the special mic prices. We usually can throw in something if you're doing a package deal. We keep it on your account. We do offer the full line of colors, but they are actually testing a half-size version of this at some of the Costcos this holiday season, which is kind of a bitter subject because we love new products and I can't sell it. So I would hope that you would wait for me to sell it to you, but they're actually going to make a Nakiri knife, which is about that size. And if you're just like, I got to have that knife, feel free to go to Costco and buy it. I'm not desperate for business, but you know I'll take care of you if you're ready. But if it sells well at Costco, there's a chance it'll come out next year for the reps. So keep that in mind. It's going to be basically kind of like a petite santoku, but a vegetable style knife. So that'll be the 7th knife in the chopping Cutco catalog there. So guys, thanks for watching. Reach out if I can ever help, and feel free to comment or message me with any questions. Take care, everybody. What's your favorite? Feel free to let me know.